Yo ho ho, yo ho 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 ho, yo ho 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 ho. Sailing on the stormy seas, living the life of a pirate, craziness, calamity, be caused by a new virus. Hey guys, this is Silver 5150 here with 25 of the Queen Anne's Revenge Black Flag Blackbeard coins from the Tuvalu Mint, well, the Perth Mint. Tuvalu, and these things here are hotter than Hades, man. These are some hot coins for 2019. They're 4.9's fine. They are just minted to perfection, and the mintage, I think, is probably like 15,000. I don't know if these coins are popular because of the theme. I don't know if it's because of the character Blackbeard, Edward Teach. He was a huge figure in pirate history. Or if it's just the actual design of the coin. If you look at the ship really close here, you can see how they've gone through the trouble to make sure you can see the tears inside of the, you know, sails and the reeds in the wood on the ship and the waves, you know, even the birds, you know, in the clouds and stuff. Once you get it, you can see in the texture of the clouds, they just went all out on this coin. And let's check out the back here real quick. In the back here, you can see that they've got the queen, which I guess is proof against frost finish. So this coin, I guess, would be proof-like, right? Is that what you got to say? Be proof-like or, you know, maybe PU? It's, what do you call it? Proof uncirculated or, yeah. Anyway, so these coins came out, and I mean, the broker, man, I will talk about him until the day I croak. Toes up, I will be praising the greatness of the broker. He found these on pre-sale at Apmex, I think in the 20s, all right? You try to price these things online right now, you know, eBay or Amazon or whoever might have them, if they're even up for grabs now, and they're commanding anywhere from 55 to 75 bucks a piece. So, I mean, just an excellent, excellent coin to have, and an excellent, excellent theme for tonight, talking about the freedom of a pirate's life. Now, that was one of the things that I wanted to do with Silver 5150 on location, was to sail the seven seas, you know, be it, you know, mostly by cruise ship, you know, maybe some, you know, merchant marine stuff, and just go around and check out different lands and stuff and be one of those guys that's eating everything in sight and telling you how good or how bad it is, but that's not going to materialize for some time now. But anyway, you can imagine what it's like living that kind of life. Back then, it wasn't a very easy life, but today, you know, on Silver Sea or, you know, Norwegian or Princess or one of those, it's pretty easy to do. These coins right here are probably in my top five favorites. And that's ironic because the 5-ounce versions, which I showed you guys, I've got two of those, are in the top five also. They're just, the design is just superior. They just really, really went through a lot of trouble to make this coin great. And I guess each one has like a different ID number. So this is an ID 150, 193, and this one's ID, oh no, that's just the ID number of the mark for Apmex. So now, you guys, if you don't know about Apmex Mint Direct, how they work their thing, Apmex Mint Direct, especially now they're doing their stuff with PGCS, basically what Apmex is saying is, we found a lot of these coins, a lot, you know, like a huge group of them. And we went through them, and we found the best of the best of the best, and we put them in our Mint Direct stack. Now, the Mint Direct stack can be Mint Direct Premier, but you get this special casing in this covering from Apmex that protects the coin. It's not a capsule, per se, but it is very hard plastic, and it is wedged in there really good, and it's protected, of course, airtight, and it has the Apmex, you know, guarantee on it, okay? But here is the downside. I've sold some Apmex Mint Direct stuff to Apmex, and do you know, when you do that, they act as if it's nothing special. Oh, well, it's just bulk silver. Okay, well, yeah, but it's your Apmex Mint Direct. Yeah, yeah, we know, but we don't really, you know. But doesn't that mean it's the best? Well, okay, that's a little disappointing, thinking you're going to get some premium back from buying their Mint Direct stuff, because when you pay for it, it's premium to get the Apmex Mint Direct stuff. So maybe that was just one instance where that happened. Sorry about the finger there. But it's happened to me a couple of times. I bought some ballerinas, some Palladium ballerinas way back, sold them back, and then getting a special premium for them. Anyway, so these are some great coins to have. The pirate's life is what we're kind of looking at, where we're going to actually have to be freer and more independent, looks like now. You did hear the governments talking about helicopter money, at least our government talking about, you know, $1,000, you know, for every man, woman, and child here in the next few days, and then I think another $1,000 before that, I mean, after that, and then on towards the end of the year, about $18,000 per person. Well, I mean, I get where they're coming from, and I get what they're trying to do, but we're basically talking about covering everybody for everything, everywhere in the United States. That includes businesses, and that includes people's private lives and stuff, and I just don't think our central bank can do it. I think it's going to blow the dollar wide open, and of course, when that happens, and it might even be happening now if you look at the premiums on metal, metal is going to step up automatically, organically, naturally, as the next currency people are going to want to use. People are going to want to use it. So I've made it a point just to get a variety of everything I could get my hands on. You guys, you know how voracious I am when it comes to silver. I've got a friend that's got a bunch of cash, and I have no cash. I have no cash until payday on Friday. I have to wait till Friday, and I have to pray that there's something left on the shelves because I know how you guys are. You're just as hungry for cheap silver as I am. And when I say cheap, I don't mean cheap in the sense that, you know, it doesn't have, you know, great value. Cheap as in the spot price is low, even though the premiums are just as high as the spot price. But essentially, guys, for what this really is, for what silver is really going to be able to do, for what it's really going to be valued at in dollar terms, the price right now is free, especially in this time of ultimate crisis. I find a greater misunderstood crisis in our history. I challenge you. Okay? We understand war. We understand, you know, what the Nazis were doing. We understood, you know, what was going on in the Middle East. We understand those kind of crises. We even understand when there were so many other viruses around. But this one right here, we still haven't quite got a bead on the survivability yet. And so it makes it very enigmatic and kind of scary. So we are in ultimate crisis right now. And you're telling me in ultimate crisis, we have the lowest spot prices we've had in 13 years? That's not the truth. The truth is that this metal here, silver, is going to outperform anything that's ever been under the sun when the time comes. And that time might be sooner or later. They're pumping out, you know, these checks, they're cranking out the cash. That's just our country. Like I said, Italy's doing other things like, you know, declaring moratorium on mortgage payments. I'm sure there's other countries doing other things too to support their people and compensate their people. And this is all done through the central banks at the behest of the governments. So it is a grand, you know, design thing, you know, for them to think, you know, well, they're trying to basically keep calamity down by supporting the financial markets in the hope that we can hold our stuff together long enough to actually defeat the menace, the problem, the COVID-19 coronavirus. But I don't even know what the heck I wanted to talk about tonight. I guess I wanted to talk about let's finish clearing the shelves this week. Guys, save me a little bit of silver. I know I kind of said like, well, don't buy any silver. I'm going to buy it all. Well, I don't have any cash till Friday. So I can't really stop you from you know, buying the rest of the silver. But, you know, if you just leave me a fork or something, a knife, maybe a locket, you know, maybe just something, you know, chain links. If you know, there's no, like, little you know, bracelet chain links, that, you know, sterling silver, I'll take those. Anything that's left on Friday, I'm going to try to scoop up with my $777.77 to herald the end of the retail silver market. That doesn't mean silver won't be out there. It will be out there, but you're going to have to really dig to find it. It won't be easy to order or get online. And then we'll go into the next phase of trying to survive this issue, this virus that we have to deal with. And we can go on about preparing to live a pirate's life. Okay, guys, I think that's really all I got. I can tell you right now that I love these coins, and I'm going to try to get some more coins on Friday. I don't think there'll be another coin as awesome as this, though I do believe it's part of a series. I do believe there's going to be another, you know, Tuvaluan pirate's coin coming out. So keep an eye out for it. It'll be from Tuvalu, same guys that bought you the stuff from Marvel, same guys that bring you a lot of stuff from the popular movies, even The Simpsons. And they just make some really cool coins. Try to get them as early as you can, because the earlier you get the coins before they start to appreciate, you get a better deal, assuming the retail market is still up and running. All right, this is good stuff. Looks like the futures are up tonight. Looks like silver and gold are finally getting a bid. And that means that silver will float around into 12s and gold will float around into 15s. And we'll see what the other metals are going to do. Not too concerned about those. This is the one metal we're really concerned about because it's been beat down the hardest. It's probably the most valuable overall. And we want to see if it's going to show any of that strength next week after we buy everything this week. Right, guys? We're going to buy all the silver this week. You guys get what you want between now and Friday morning. I'm going to get the rest on Friday morning. All right. Like, share, subscribe, comment, and I'll see you guys in the morning with an update.